Hi guys, thanks for joining me on this co-op flight with Hover82. Click his logo to follow to his channel and subscribe to him. And please try to view this video in 60 frames. See the description for how to, because it's much smoother then. We met here in Sebenstein near the Türkensturz and wanted to fly up with our two TBS Discoveries. And I taped my Discovery, so orange, for my friend to see my copter better, because they are really hard to see in the air. But here it worked so well that he could chase me all the way up to the Türkensturz here in the background, and we got some really nice shots. You see how the copter ascends over the treetops. This is the nice climbing wall. And you even see two hikers down there. And this is the Türkensturz. I already told this and I filmed here before. There are some legends about falling down girls that wanted to evade from Turkish army in the medieval times. But all the ruins here are built ruins from some landlord here, so not real ruins, fake ruins. Yeah, there's a bike trail up here. You see me filming the friend, and he's not painted, so he's harder to find in the air. And the beautiful panorama of the surrounding villages. Once again you see him shortly. This must be my copter. And the meet and greet of copters is a standard now, and it's nice to see other people reacting on your copter, and I'm not sure what he wanted to show him, yeah. That really looks nice here. It was nice weather conditions, not much wind as I remember, but clouds with rain would come after these flights. So it really looks best if you fly in close proximity to trees or rocks. And then we had to descend all the way down to the fields you see left down there. I made a manual mode dive, which is still a bit freaking me, but you can lose height much faster this way. And you switch to attitude mode shortly over the field. And because it was quite warm this day, you search the shadows. I switched to line of sight mode for landing. And here you see Hover82 sitting in his typical pose. Next you see what can happen if you make a few errors and they all sum up. First error, start under a tree. Also acquire satellites there and thus saving the home point there. Then flying away in a hurry because your friend already was in the air. Sorry for the green bars, these are damaged GoPro files that I had to repair. So then we wanted to fly to these ruins over there, and about this far it somehow felt weird, and now it ran into failsafe and I had no idea initially why. It, as it's told, does failsafe, turns around and wants to fly home and land where I told him to. At this moment I panicked, looked up in the sky, flying in line of sight and trying to get back control, but I didn't, because I was too dumb to remember the procedure, like switching to ETI mode and back to GPS mode a few times. So it was still in descent mode, and at this time it hovered right above the tree, and I was totally freaking out down there. Then I managed to switch to manual mode with no gas, so it just sank down into the tree. See, it's still running motors. And because this tree was really high, I wanted to get it down, no matter how. So I pulled the trigger and gave some throttle, and it went down, resulting in a totally damaged GoPro 3, which was 1 month old, and not so much damage on the Discovery, just a few broken landing struts, and a video transmitter was torn apart. I found all the stuff, so damage is not too high except for the broken GoPro. What was the reason for the failsafe? Simple. I just didn't plug in my antenna in the radio. How stupid can one be? No, it was just because I did hurry to start my machine. So, points learned. Take your time for preparedness. Start in the open area for a good GPS home position. Have some sorts of a checklist, not to forget something like the antenna. And then have fun flying. Okay, so thanks for watching this good and bad FPV. Hope it helps you to avoid such unnecessary crashes and just have fun and perfect FPV flights like the first example showed. Thanks, bye. If you like these videos, check out this Türkensturz video I did in years ago with my tricopter. And also check the playlist here with FPV meetings, which really gave me a lot of fun the last years.